were no stranger to the rain. So go rest high on that mountain, the sun you work on earth is done. Go to gathered round your grave to grieve. Wish I could see angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice sing. So go rest high.
And welcome to Fort Logan, final resting place of many of America's heroes and countless men and women who have served our country with honor. American Legion Post 1187 of Castle Rock in conjunction with members of the United States Marine Corps, are privileged and honored to provide military honors for our fallen comrade, James. When James heard his country's call, he went forth with abiding faith in his God, his country, and his flag. The red of our country's flag was made redder by his heroism, the white more stainless and pure by what motivated him, the blue and starry field more royal by his service to a grateful nation. Our chaplain will lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, Father of all, amidst these monuments of the dead, we see thy hand. In the depth of our sorrow, we realize the truth of thy inspired word. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. As comrade after comrade departs, we march on with the ranks growing thinner. Help us to be faithful unto thee and to one another. We beseech thee, look in mercy upon all of us assembled, and with thine own tenderness, console and comfort those bereaved by the hand of death. Heavenly Father, bless our country with freedom, peace, and righteousness, and through thy sovereign and Holy Spirit's favor, may we all meet at last before thee, and thy great name shall be praised forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
As the years go by, we are called upon to perform these sad duties. When James heard his country's call, he joined the ranks of the young and the old. We too will march in James' footsteps. We will meet our heavenly commander for the last roll call. James' service to his country will surely be inspiring for the youth of our nation.
Our comrade is in the hands of our Heavenly Father. God giveth his beloved sleep. James will be laid to rest, but let us cherish his virtues and learn to imitate them. Let each one be so loyal to every virtue, so true to every friendship, so faithful in the remaining marches, that he will be able to fall out and take his place in the great review hereafter, not in doubt, but with faith that the merciful captain of our salvation will call him to that fraternity which on earth and in heaven remains unbroken.
I would now like to call upon the U.S. Marine Corps to unfurl the flag. The honor guard will now fire three volleys. These volleys will be quite loud and startling. Following the volleys, taps will play, and the presentation of the flag after it's folded will be given to the family. At this time, I ask if you're able to stand, place your right hand over your heart. If you are a veteran or active military, it's quite permissible at this time to salute, even if you're not in uniform. Please rise. Order, arms, please be seated.
This banner of love and devotion, now being folded, is a living memorial for the courageous thoughts of our comrade, the one you came here today to honor. The blue field represents the sky that overlooks our land and denotes the watchfulness of God the Eternal. The red stripes tell us of the blood, sweat, and tears that have been offered and conquered by our comrade's devotion to the responsible freedom of his country. The white stripes boldly proclaim the peace James helped bring to our future generations. This is his flag. This is our spiritual heritage. Receive it with the tears of our eyes and the faithfulness of our hearts.
This packet contains three spent shells signifying the three volleys that the honor guard just fired in Colonel James. This completes the military portion of our service today. We thank you for your attendance. We know James would be greatly proud at your attendance, your show of love. God bless him. God bless his family. Please take care of him. We'll turn this over to your man of God. This week that we celebrate the anniversary of our independence as a country, but the service of our brother James to his country in a time of war. Also the service of our Lord Jesus Christ to come and to die for us on this Roman instrument of torture we call the crucifix. So let us all enter into prayer for not only the soul of our brother, but for us in our grief, the family, the friends of our dear brother. So let's begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My brother Jim has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn to be reunited one day with our brother, together may we meet Christ Jesus when he, who is our life, appears in glory. Brothers and sisters, we read in Scripture, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world." Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave and resting place a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal remains. Grant that our brother Jim may sleep here in peace until you awaken him to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in the light, your light will see the light and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Almighty and ever-living God, remember the mercy with which you graced your servant James in life. Receive him, we pray, into the mansions of the saints, as we make ready our brother's resting place. Look also for favor on those who mourn, family and friends, and comfort them in their loss and their grief. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
because God has chosen to call our brother Jim from this life to himself, we will commit his body to his resting place here. For we are dust, and to dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. For he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother to the Lord, so that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise his body on the last day. For our brother, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even to death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Our response will be, Lord, have mercy. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for James, and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord, Lord, have mercy. You wept at the grave of your friend Lazarus. Cover us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord,
Lord, have mercy.
You raised the dead to life. Give to our brother eternal life. We pray to the Lord,
Lord, have mercy.
You promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring James to the joys of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Our brother was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give him fellowship with all your saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
And comfort us in our sorrow at the death of James. And let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us together say the prayer that Jesus Christ himself taught us. But let's give greater glory to God and let's sing it. Please join me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death, and through his rest in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you. And through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers. For those who have died in Christ, our brother James, and are buried and laid to rest with him in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask all this through Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Savior, wash away Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant upon him, O Lord. Let the perpetual light
shine upon him.
May he rest in peace. Amen. And may his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed,
through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. And God bless you.
You know that if you want to come back and visit his site today, it'll be ready after 4. Otherwise, we're sunrise to sunset every day, so please come back and visit.
Thank you so much. Do you guys want to?